I'll never capture the actual synchronized occurrences on tape. I don't suppose it's going to be possible. But what I can do is bear witness to it with the Piffany tape machine. So that's the game I'm playing. I'll go back to the beginning in a minute.
So before you go for Epiphany Piss, have you got any Epiphany bits to tell to us?
I haven't. Do you mean Epiphanies or Synchronicities?
What's different?
Synchronicity is where the external world responds to you. Epiphany is just something that happens within.
Where's the Zoom?
I was like catching up with the signs. That's what was happening.
It thundered as I was writing. The photos arrived. Yeah, I went and hid up their driveway.
Wow, this is what it all means. I've got to record the signs, that's what I'm here for. The aim of art is to represent things that we don't have language for. Art helps us develop the capacity for sensing these other valued registers of experience, and in sensing it, inspires us to go further in search of it, to find it in our own lives and help work towards our language for it and our understanding of it. The other that I'm interested in is the other to the physical world. It's the Unus Mundus world. That's what we need to bring into consciousness. So that's what I'm going to do from now on. See if it works, because I don't know if you can capture the Unus Mundus on if you go looking for it. Okay, check this out. Just walking along, I'm on my way to the pub thinking about, oh, should I drink or should I not? Because I never ever go to a pub and not drink. And but I really should, because I don't really feel like drinking at the moment. And anyway, it's like to not drink would be to change my spot. And I don't know if I can, but this poster's telling me that I can. And you know what makes it link up to me? Leopard print, because look what I'm wearing. I'm wearing a leopard print coat. Feeling a little, quite a lot sad about Captain Felix. I got my face, crying. And then I saw this poster in this window. And then the cat's away. I think the point is, whoa, shit. I didn't catch anything else in the window, only the cat poster. I had a dream about a week ago. The only thing that I remember from it when I woke up was that I'd looked at my mobile phone clock and the time on it had been double figures, like 21:21 or 15:15. And then after that dream, it started happening, like, not every time I looked at the clock, but with almost disturbing regularity, frequency, I mean. It was double figures when I looked at the clock. Today, I was on my way home from college, walking home, and this guy I know from the park, Dave.
Hello, Dave.
All right,
the cameraman.
After I saw Dave, I thought, oh, I've got my camera in my bag. I could have gone down and filmed him talking about synchronicity.
And he was so I thought, well, that's synchronicity.
And so I got out my mobile phone. I thought, I'll give Dave a ring. And when I took out my phone, it was 15:15 at the time. So I'm going to go out in search of the Unus Mundus right now. I was just putting my shoes on, getting ready to go out the door. Well, putting my shoes on. And my phone starts ringing, Jimmy the Hat. So yeah, that's where I'm going to go first and just see what it turns up. That's so weird. I'm just on my way down to Jimmy's, and as I'm walking down here, I'm going past Dawn's house. Dawn's a girl that Tim got off with, my best friend got off with and abandoned me for. And I had real issues with her.
He's just gonna be like Dad, I suppose, where he just, you know, gets his new life and doesn't want anything to do with the old one.
I just thought, oh, I wonder if I'm going to see Dawn, like synchronicity and all that. And I did. She just walked straight past me just as I'm coming up to Jim's house now, which is where I am. Ah, Jim, man. I was supposed to fucking get in. I'm alright, how are you?
Just having an out chill.
Ah, excellent. Do you believe in synchronicity?
Oh, very much so. I'll tell you a quick story about synchronicity.
Yeah, tell me as many stories as you like.
I'd love you to have this one on film.
Yeah, tell me all of them.
1987, skint in Birmingham, personal issue in Glastonbury, right? So I had to get a lift from here to Glastonbury. And it was one of those days when the rain really came down, baby. Mm. It was like... Right, it was a rainy day. And you walk up to the slip road and there's like a little roundabout and you stand there and hitch a lift to Glastonbury. Mm. And this guy stopped in this small truck. And I went, go to Glastonbury, mate. And he went, no, mate, I'm going to Taunton. The Glastonbury Road speeds up really quick and Taunton goes off like that. And if you get stuck there, the traffic's going past you like, so you can't get a lift. So I said, I'll hang on here, mate, for somebody that's going through. And he went, OK, mate, shut the door and drove off. 5 minutes later, this lady pulled up in the car. I said, are you going to Glastonbury, dear? She said, yes, get in. I threw my bag in the back and we're driving up towards the turn off to Taunton. And there's this big, horrific accident. And the guy in the truck who I'd refused the lift with was crushed to death like that.
Oh, my God.
Right? And I got into Glastonbury, mate, and I walked into the nearest boozer and got a double brandy down me as quick as I could. I was shaking all over. And the word you just mentioned, Charlie Wrighton's wife, I think her name was Evelyn, she was in the pub having a glass of Guinness. And she said, what the devil's wrong with you, James? They used to call me James. And I sat and told her what had happened. And she said, James, it's called synchronicity. And you weren't meant to be in that, man. You know what I mean? And I've never forgot it, you know? And that thing about what will be, there was a great witchy song called Green Grow the Rushes, oh. Did you know that one?
No.
And it's one is one and all is one and always so shall be so, green grow the rushes, oh, right? But the realisation that, you know, the universe is moving all the time. Mm. Every insect, every piece of soil, the whole thing.
And all you have to do is tap into, like, your feeling inner guide and just go with the flow and follow it and allow it to move you where it wants you to. You know, allowing me to come here today and have this conversation with you. Like, because I've set... This is what my mission is tonight. I've set out to follow the fairy signs in a way. Do you see? Like, it's led me here. Do you believe in synchronicity?
Oh, very much so. I'll tell you a quick story about synchronicity.
Yeah, tell me as many stories as you like. I'd love you to have this one on film. Yeah, tell me all of them.
1987, skint in Birmingham, personal issue in Glastonbury, right?
I have this theory about the whole double numbers on the clock thing as well, like, and what the dream meant, in what it is as a symbol. Chairs in Jimmy's house, the sun and the moon.
Aye, made them myself.
Did you?
Aye.
Wow. For the last month, I've been seeing this bloke. Me and my fella was just talking about the sun and the moon the other day.
You and who?
Me and my fella.
Who, Maddie?
Yeah.
I like Maddie.
Do you? He's helping me reunite my masculine and feminine sides, find balance between them.
There was a great witchy song called Green Grow the Rushes, oh. Did you know that one?
No. For there to be unity between two numbers, like 15-15. Just speaks of balance somehow, integration. All is one with the world kind of thing.
And it's one is one and all is one and always so shall be so, green grow the rushes, oh, right?
Finding this balance and becoming whole.
And I sat and told her what had happened and she said, James, it's called synchronicity.
Okay, so that turned out to be a good move because I followed the fairy signs and the feelings. I trusted that the universe would provide if I went out in search of it. So I'm just gonna follow my path for the rest of the evening, see where it takes me. I've got some ideas as well, like I've forgotten what they are now. I'll think about it for a minute and let you know. I suppose I kind of had it in my head as well that I was going into the centre of Moseley. But now I'm not going to because I'm smoking this bliff and the police station's that way. So my feelings tell me not to go that way. And look who I should bump into. I would have missed you if I'd have gone the other way.
Is that synchronicity?
Yeah.
following the path. It led me to Jimmy the Hat.
Wow.
And Jimmy the Hat gave me some good stuff.
And now you're getting a load of more good meaty...
Yeah. Where are you off to?
Well, I'm just going to go and have a walk around the lake.
Hmm. How come?
Okay. Did you go to the lake earlier?
No.
You're just studging up your backlog with more wadges of useless rubbish.
You don't get it.
What?
You don't get it. Ah, slug trail. The passage of time.
It's not polite to go into someone's house actually smoking.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm here. Tim's here too. Thanks for having us.
Hello, Dave. I'm
all right,
the cameraman.
Yeah, I've come all the way up the stairs.
Like seven.
Oh yeah. Okay. Yeah. Exhibit one. Yeah. I was in Moseley, just moved into College Road, and one of those gas fires, one of the elements was bust on mine. And I went down College Road, and I saw this gas fire, and I thought, oh, right, yeah, there'll be an element in there for me gas fire, yeah. But this was leaning on top of it like that. So I picked it up. So that was my first skip find in Moseley. Right. Ace of Spades. I've been evicted from 163 College Road and moved next door to 161. Yeah. And that night the woman from next door said to me, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? And I said to her, well, I think I need an ace. I need a big ace. And the next day, unbeknownst to us going, my mates knocked 163 College door and he asked me if I wanted this. And he'd found it the day before working on the border of Wales in a house in a little alcove, bricked in.
Is there a story attached to that big sign, the big roundabout sign?
The magic roundabout.
Is it magic?
Yeah, it's a magic roundabout. Actually, it was this summer in the park. I found the roundabout sign.
That one?
Yeah. And it's a mini roundabout sign, which was on the street for some reason. They'd missed some car and knocked it over or something like that. Mm. And I ended up in the private park with Brian and Dougal.
Oh my god!
And it was like the most roundabout.
Oh my god!
I had this kind of experience where I was totally feeling the whole signs running through my body, and they were coming to me all the time. And I went out and all these thoughts started coming into my head about like the masculine and the feminine needing to become kind of integrated with each other. And the masculine and feminine is like dark and light, and the conscious and the unconscious, and this, and the, almost the good and the evil, though that's not to say that the one is the one. One is the good and one is the evil. It's like...
No, that's society's mire that you'd be coming bogged in with that.
Well, I've had those signs in another way.
Came out as a union.
What, in what way did those signs come out, the union?
Well, for some reason it keeps coming out as a lion and unicorn.
Brilliant.
The lion being the masculine and the unicorn being the feminine.
I guess so, yeah, I guess so. But it keeps coming up. And so far, I found some lion and unicorn buttons in a skip, brass ones. And my friend had a vision. He went to live in town, in Birmingham. And he had a vision. He had a vision of a lion and a unicorn united. And came to see me afterwards. And he handed me a key. And he said, and it had a union on it. And he said, Dave, union. I was like, yeah, union. Lion, unicorn. He said, look, union. Half lion, half unicorn. So that was telling me that the signs I was receiving were the same signs other people were receiving.
Mm.
Which tells me that those people have got something to do with each other in the future again.
Yeah. Yeah, and the lion is like, in some, like, represents kind of brute strength, doesn't it? While the unicorn is more about magic and the things that aren't about the survival world, I suppose.
I've seen them represented as sun and moon as well. You know?
Yeah.
Very, very, anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, sun
lion. Sun and moon. And they've been, sun and moons have been coming up as well.
Mm. Me and my fella was just talking about the sun and the moon the other day.
You and who?
Me and my fella.
Oh, Maddie.
Yeah.
And it's one is one and all is one and always so shall be so green grow the rushes, oh, right?
What time do things start at the church, you know? What time is this, the prayer? What time is the bell
ringing?
What time is the communion?
It's like, I don't know. I don't know, it's like, I think it will be on about 8. What time is it?
It'll only be about 7-ish, won't it, now, I think.
That's gone dark early.
Oh, yeah.
What? Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God. Whoa, you caught one.
Yeah, but it's not accurate.
Classic.
I've just come to Tim's house. He invited me in for a sausage. And he's, not only has he given me a sausage, this smelly cock phallic symbol, but to go with it, the feminine cheese, it's the milk of the Mother Earth. I'm integrated, although the sausage is bigger at the moment than the cheese. But the cheese is more like of a delicacy. Whoa, did you see the symbolism in that? That's fucking society, that. A big massive sausage and a little tiny bit of cheese. Huge amount of masculinity. Mmm.
Delay on that.
I just got home from my Epiphany journey, just about to take my shoes off, and realised that I'm wearing my rainbow socks. The rainbow's caught the magic. You can't see it properly with these, with this camera, because the colours are all to cock, but trust me, that's a rainbow. And the rainbow is the union of the masculine and the feminine, the water and the fire, the water and the light. Wow. And that's kind of like Maddie. He's the fire, and I'm the water, like the soft one. He's fiery and prickly. Maybe I should lean back a bit. I don't know. He's fiery and prickly, and I'm soft and watery, and together we make a rainbow. Oh no, my computer's going slow.
just realised that all signs are like rainbows. The same way that when you look at a rainbow, all that you can say is there is what your brain interprets of it. It's only our brains that can see rainbows like that. It's a process of the mind interpreting it. You just need to use it.